Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how to create this Bauhaus inspired design in Adobe Illustrator. It's super easy and so much fun, and every time you create one, you create something unique and different. So let's jump right in and give it a go. Hi, I'm Mel Armstrong, a surface pattern designer and illustrator from Wellington, New Zealand. On this channel, I provide tutorials and tips for illustrators, surface pattern designers, and anything in between. Okay, to start, let's click on New File and create a 12 by 12 inch square canvas. You could also create a canvas in a different size. Just make sure it's square because that just makes it a little bit easier. Then click on Create. First thing I want to do is create a square background, and so I'm just going to click on the rectangle tool, click on the canvas, and then type in the size of my artboard, and that is 12 by 12 inches. And then I'm just going to change the background to black and change the stroke to none, and then center that on my artboard. I then want to go to Object, Object Path, and then Split into Grid. And you have a few options here. I'm going to split mine into a 6x6. If we turn on the preview, you can see that it's split it into a 6x6 grid. You could also make it a 12x12, or you could make it an 8x8, just as long as it's even. So what this is doing is creating 2-inch squares for me to work with. So I'm going to click on OK. And then if you click on the direct selection tool and then click out, you can then click on individual squares individually. So what I'm going to do is create a copy of this individual square here. So I'm holding down the option, clicking and dragging, and then I'm going to duplicate that a few more times. I've got about 5 squares there, and I'm going to turn each of these squares into a shape that will fit into these squares nicely. So I'm going to keep the first one as a square. Let's turn this one into a circle. So I'm just going to grab one of these anchor tools here and drag in. So that's a click and a drag to create a circle. And then we can create a half circle by doing similar, but this time just clicking twice on that one of the corners and then dragging in so that it only curves that one corner. And then let's get a bit more interesting here. Let's create a circle again and then divide this in two. So I'm going to grab my line tool and I'm going to click on the left anchor, holding down the mouse click and then dragging to the right anchor. And then if we select both of those and then go to the Pathfinder and then click on divide, and that will separate the two halves. And then let's ungroup those and then select the bottom one and rotate it to create these sort of half moon effects, and then I might group them back together again. And then for this one I might do a triangle, so the same thing, using the line tool, select it and then divide it, and then ungroup it, and then rotate it, and then move that one down. And then I need to resize these so that it fits inside a 2x2 square. So I'm selecting both of them. I'm going to go to the properties panel and just change the width and height to 2 inches. And then I'm just going to line that back up there. So we've got 5 different shapes there, and actually I need to group that last one. And I'm just going to make some copies of those. So I'm selecting them all, holding down the Option key and dragging to create a copy, and then Command D to duplicate a couple more times. And then I want to color these. So I'm going to go to my swatch panel and just bring in a swatch that I have created. And then select the first row and let's fill this with this blue and then pink and then orange and so on. So you just want a mix of colors that work well together. And now I want to place these. I will duplicate them and rotate them to fit in each of these squares. Now there are some scripts out there that you can use that will do this automatically, but I actually prefer to do it manually, so that's how I'm going to show you how to do it. So to make it easier, I'm actually going to go and turn on the grid. So I want to change the color, let's say magenta, just to make it a little bit brighter. I'm going to have a grid every 2 inches, as that is the size of my squares, and a subdivision of 1. And then we need to make sure we can see it, so go to View, Show Grid. And then now we can see it. And if we also turn on Snap to Grid, it'll just make it a bit easier when we're dragging our shapes in. So basically now I'm just going to randomly fill in these squares with my shapes. I'll do some rotating to make them all look a bit different, and some duplication of some as well. I might even put some on top of the others to create some really interesting shapes. I might even divide out these triangles and make it just one triangle, but I will just go with the flow. I kind of like just to do it organically and not really think too hard about it, and just watch it grow as I do it. So I will speed this up and see you at the other side. Okay, I'm happy with that. And one last thing I want to show you is how to create a pattern repeat from this. And so I'm just going to select it all, go up to Object, Pattern, Make. And then you want to make sure the width and the height is the same size as your canvas. And you can change the tile type. You could leave it as a grid, or you could change it to brick by row, or brick by column, and that will mix things up quite a bit. You can also change it by quarter or by one third, and I'm just going to leave that at one half, and I'm going to go back to the brick by row, so I quite like that one. And then once you're happy, just click done and it will add it to your swatch panel, and we can test that out by just creating a large rectangle using the rectangle tool, and then clicking on that swatch repeat tile, and there you have it. And let's turn off the grid so we don't see it. And there is our final pattern. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please consider liking and subscribing. It really helps support the channel and allows me to create more tutorials like this. For more pattern design inspiration and tutorials, check out this playlist. See ya!